What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over the CoFH Core Mod in Minecraft. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. When playing on your Forge Minecraft server, you, as a server owner, might want remote access to features like ender chests or other things. This is possible with CoFH Core, a Minecraft mod that provides essential commands and functions to improve your gameplay experience. Additionally, the mod is a foundation for CoFH addons to give you more control over the world and items. The mod works automatically, however, there are a variety of configurations that are available to tweak the permissions and other features. In this tutorial, we'll go over the CoFH Core mod to get you started on your Forge server. The first thing that you will have to do is install the mod on both the launcher and the server. Head towards the CoFH Core CurseForge page and then press Files. Scroll down until you see the version that you want and click on the mod's name, and afterwards click Download to begin the download onto your computer. Once you have that, make sure it's saved to a convenient location for later. Open your launcher's mod folders and drag the mod into here. This process can be different depending on your launcher, but for Forge, check out our guide that we will have linked down below. Open the game to see if it loads to confirm that the mod installation worked. Make sure to have the mod downloaded onto your computer before moving on to the server installation. Head to your Apex server panel and click on FTP file access in the top left. Log in, and on the next page, enter the mod's directory. Press upload in the top left and then drag the mod to download. Once it has completely downloaded, you can return to the main panel page and restart the server. CoFH Core supports Minecraft Forge 1.6.4 to 1.18.2 versions, which means most servers can run it without problems. It's the main modification for other CoFH mods provided by the CoFH team, but that means that there aren't too many features for it. However, it does come with some handy functions that you or your players can use. The main focus for the CoFH Core are the commands, which offer enhancing features for your server. You can do things like CoFH crafting to immediately open the GUI to craft items, or use CoFH ender chest to open your ender chest without having the block. Here is the 1.18.2 command list for you to go over. For each version of the mod that you have, the commands are going to change, so make sure to check out which commands you should be using by going to the CoFH official wiki. There are minor settings for you to review and edit if you want, such as permission levels to the commands, but remember, this is all optional. You can access the main configuration file in your world's server config folder from the FTP panel. The file's name is CoFH Core Server, which you can review by pressing Edit to the far right of it. It'll display fishing, world, command, and other settings that are controlled by specific values. For example, the fishing exhaustion amount option is controlled by a range of 0 to 10 exhaustion. There are many add-ons for CoFH Core, but unfortunately, most are made for Minecraft 1.12.2 and not really any of the higher versions of the game. If you are interested, here's a list of the add-ons that are available for you to use. CoFH Core is a great tool to manage minor features in your server and allows for convenient commands like the crafting command or fishing exhaustion option. Though it is available up to 1.18.2, using Minecraft 1.12.2 is going to be your best option since this mod is mainly used for its add-ons. Regardless, the CoFH Core mod will make your server better due to its functionality and helpfulness. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.